Penguin Random House Audio presents Double Down. Bet on yourself and succeed on your terms. Written
and read by Antoinette M. Clarke
and Tricia Clarke-Stone. For Grandma, the OG boss lady who taught us to love big and hustle hard.
Whose faith in us inspired us to become our best and most unique selves. Introduction. Welcome to the new American hustle. Let's get started. There are two types of people in this world. There's the kind who see power in another person and seek to negate it. And there's the kind who see power in themselves and seek to nurture it. You are the second kind of person. You're listening to this audiobook because you're ready to become the person you know you can be. You're ready to become successful on your terms and to be rewarded for who you are, not held back for who you're not. You're done taking advice from people who don't have your best interests at heart. You're sick and tired of being told to wait your turn, pay your dues, follow the rules. You bought this audiobook because you're ready to bet on yourself and surround yourself with people you will bet on too. Because once you nurture the power that's in yourself, you'll go on to nurture the power in others.
Ever since we were little girls, growing up in a single-parent household in Ditmas Park, Brooklyn, mom holding it down like a G, we've pushed each other to be successful on our own terms, offering unconditional support, straight talk, and passionate inspiration. That's how we got to where we are today, and that's what we want to share with you. As African-American women, we've learned a thing or two about owning and operating our confidence, dealing with adversity, and going high when they go low. As identical twins, we know the power of a partner in crime who always has your back, as well as the absolute necessity to individuate. As first-generation Americans, our parents came here from Jamaica in their teens. We grew up with that better-yourself mentality that all children of immigrants possess.
Refining what we've learned from these experiences and more, we've helped hundreds of women identify their goals, trust their instincts and core passions, and go all in on their superpowers. Now we want to do the same for you. We're going to give you all the tools, tricks, and tactics we've learned over the years to help you unlock your best self. We want to help you hustle harder, shine brighter, soar higher, and bank more. It doesn't matter whether you're kicking ass and taking names as an entrepreneur, making a mid-career switch, or just starting out at the bottom of the corporate ladder. You have the power to go to the next level. The next level is being a boss lady in whatever hustle you're running.
What exactly is a boss lady? Everyone knows at least one or two boss ladies. Boss ladies are found in all professions, in all pursuits, and all things. Because boss ladies transcend all professions, all pursuits, all things. Boss lady is a mode of being, an essence, irreducible, elemental. Boss ladies inspire us, support us, believe in us, trust us. They make us want to be better.
Boss ladies make decisions, not problems. They command, they don't demand. They don't promise, they deliver. They want to make us better, not stay the same. They answer, they don't prevaricate. They help us be our own best selves. Not low-res versions of them. They press play, not repeat.
Boss ladies show grace under pressure, not fear. They act fearless, but they feel fear sometimes. They just know that fear is power, raw. They refine fear into energy, into power. They are power.
And we know that you are one of them. Don't feel like one? By the end of this book, you will.
The art of the double down, beating the house. Here's the deal. Life is a game of blackjack. Again and again, you're being dealt a hand of cards, and it's up to you to calculate risk. Play out scenarios in your head, know your competition, keep your cool, and play to win. Everyone knows the point of blackjack is to get, well, blackjack or 21. But wait, that's not the point of blackjack. The point of blackjack is to beat the house. That's how you get cash. See, the odds always favor the house in blackjack. That's how the casinos stay in business. The house has been playing this game for years. It literally wrote the rules. The house calls the shots. It works the odds. The house tries to distract you with free drinks and flashing lights, illusions meant to knock you off your game.
What the house doesn't want you to know is this. You can beat it if you play smart and disciplined. Going up against the house isn't easy, but if you want to win, you need to learn how to spot the opportunities where you have a calculable advantage. And then you need to double down on it. Doubling down is going all in when you know you have the odds on your side. It's banking hard on the edge you've got.
In life, the status quo is just like the house. The status quo is everywhere. It's all the people and systems trying to hold you back, asking you to settle for less, and giving you second-class rewards for first-class work. It's pernicious. It can even manifest within you as self-doubt and fear, as obstacles to girls, women, and minorities, as a weight that is dragging you down.
The status quo wrote the rules. It holds all the cards, and it will try to knock you off your game in every way it can. It'll try to distract you with false promises and bad role models. It'll try to get inside your head and mess with your heart. It'll convince you that you're always playing catch-up to an ideal that doesn't exist.
The status quo is the yin to the boss lady's yang. They are locked in an eternal struggle. It's the voice that tells you not to raise your hand or speak up. That voice that says, don't bother chasing that opportunity. That voice that tells you not to take the microphone and speak the truth.
That's the status quo. The time you spend worrying whether to wear this or that skirt when you want to be working on your pitch, acquiescing to your male colleague's request to finish our work and email it to him, thinking that the only way to get ahead is to follow the accepted way of doing things.
That's the status quo. Being forced to choose between happiness and work, thinking that you can get rich quick if only you get the one right contact or take the right meeting,
That's the status quo, too. The status quo is a wily bastard, but all it takes is one winning hand to take him down. That winning hand is you, boss lady.
To beat the house, you need to do two things. You need to double down on you, and you need to double down on your crew. You need to move quickly to get ahead, where you spot an opening for yourself, where your passion and your unique skill set will propel you as you blaze a new path forward.
You need to go all in on yourself like yesterday. You need to bet on your unique collection of experiences, passions, desires, the way you see and feel things, rather than trying to compete with everyone else on all fronts in all the same ways. And you need to double down on a solid and loyal crew who will bet on you and whom you can bet on too. Because if you do those two things, you'll be unstoppable. That's what the art of the double down is all about.
Same, same, but different. Before we start downloading you on how to take over the world, we want to tell you a bit about us.
I'm Antoinette Clarke.
And I'm Tricia Clarke-Stone.
Best friends.
Business partners.
Black women.
Hustlers.
Boss ladies.
And identical twins.
Or as Elle Magazine called us, power twins.
As advertising, branding, tech, and media experts, we've helped celebrities, startups, household brands, and Fortune 500 companies tell their stories and connect with millions of people. You know, it took some hustle to get where we are today.
Tricia started her career selling radio ad spots for a media company, which meant cold calling businesses, using a phone book and a landline, and trying to convince them to advertise on the company's airwaves. Through hard work, creative savvy, and soaking up everything she could learn about the power of storytelling, she is now the CEO and co-founder of the creative and tech agency WP Narrative. Of the 8,734 CEOs of companies in the media and advertising world, only 93 are Black women. Tricia is one of the 93.
Antoinette started out as a production assistant, making less than $25,000 a year and working so hard trying to make it in the cutthroat world of TV that she didn't even have time to go home most nights, opting instead for the one-star, not-so-luxury sleep pod she created under her desk. 2 Emmy Awards and several career pivots later, she is now Vice President of Branded Entertainment and Media Innovation at CBS.
As you'll see from the stories we'll tell throughout this book, we've worked hard and played hard to get to where we are. And through it all, the Everest highs and the ocean floor lows, we've always been there for each other. When I was working those 15-hour days as a PA in my 20s, making less than $400 a week, Trish helped pay for joint vacations to places like Tulum.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.